In this video, I'm gonna talk about the areas of Tampa that I recommend most when people reach out to me. Stick around. I'm Sam, and welcome to the Living in Tampa, Florida channel, where every single week we release videos about what it's like to live, work, play, and move to the Tampa, Florida area. If that's something you want to follow along with, make sure you hit the subscribe button and the little bell so you don't miss any videos. Also, I am a licensed realtor in the state of Florida, so if you have any real estate specific questions, please don't hesitate to reach out. Call, text, or email is fine. Also, if you wanted to schedule a meeting, I've got a link down in the description for my calendar. Sometimes I've set aside to schedule 30-minute Zoom or phone call meetings with people like you. All right, today I want to talk about the most recommended areas. Recently, I did a video about the top 8 suburbs, and that was really taking some information from the public. I want to talk about the areas that I end up recommending the most when people reach out to me. And I end up recommending these areas for all kinds of reasons. So it's not like these are my favorite areas, but these are the most likely to be recommended areas in Tampa whenever people are moving here. Number one is the Brandon Riverview area. People that want to live in this Brandon area usually reach out to me and already want to live there. So it's not like I'm recommending it, but it is the most common requested place. And it's often requested because it has a nice feel. It's very kind of suburban feeling with a little bit of like rural access, but also pretty easy access to like downtown Tampa. If you're interested in building a house, this area is really common because you can get a lot of house for your money. Compared to some of the other areas that are a little bit closer to downtown, you can get a lot more for your money out in Brandon. And it is about 30 minutes from downtown, which is really not too bad of a commute if you do have to work in that area. In Brandon, you can get that 4-3 house with a pool for a little over $400,000. And those are pretty new and pretty updated often. Houses do move pretty fast in this area, but you can still find them. You know, it might just take a few tries. Okay, the number two most recommended area when people reach out to me is the Wesley Chapel, Lutz, and New Tampa area. You see it right here on the map. It's just north of Tampa, kind of starting with New Tampa, which is in Hillsborough County. And then up into Wesley Chapel and Lutz, which is in Pasco County, and even over into Land O'Lakes. Wesley Chapel is kind of New Tampa and Wesley Chapel are the most developed and suburban feeling parts of this. Some areas of Lutz and Land O'Lakes are quite a bit more like rural feeling, but you might like that. You might, you know, want a bigger yard. This pandemic has actually pushed people to have bigger lots and bigger houses. So this is an area where you can also get a lot for your money. For example, it was in December of 2020, I helped a client purchase a house in Land O'Lakes that was on a nice sized lot in a really, really cool neighborhood. This house was a 4-3 with a pool, and we bought it for $315,000. And this was an older house that had been updated, and those prices might be a little higher now, but that just kind of shows you what is possible. And you know, maybe that's $330,000 now, but it's still quite a bit cheaper than other areas. Wesley Chapel is also great for new construction. There are a lot of new communities being built in Wesley Chapel. Something very interesting about these communities, the bigger ones are, you know, owned by a developer and not by a builder. So then they hire these builders to build throughout the neighborhood. So each little section of the neighborhood looks different, even though they all share the same amenities, they all share the same HOA. It might be a different builder. You know, they'll kind of do like one block is one builder and another block is a different one. And then they'll have one area that's just like super mixed with all the builders. And it encourages the builders to keep the quality really high, to keep that customer satisfaction really high. And those are very, very interesting neighborhoods. One thing to keep in mind about those neighborhoods, especially those extremely developed ones, is you're gonna have CDD fees, community development deed. So what this is really just money to build out all of the infrastructure related to a new community like this, and you pay it back in connection with your property taxes. So this is anywhere from $1,500 to $3,000 a year, and that usually lasts about the time of the first mortgage on the house, so around 30 years from when the house was built. Okay, number three most recommended area, Westchase. Westchase is kind of right in the middle of town, and you've probably seen my like vlog tour of Westchase, and I've referenced it in other videos, and this is a master planned area. Westchase is really just a zip code, 33626. It's not its own town, it's still part of Tampa. It's very kind of dense suburban feeling, but very thoughtful. Each house has pretty easy access to accessible roads, shopping. The Citrus Park Mall is very close to there, which is a Westfield mall. Even the airport and international mall, even downtown, is all pretty accessible from Westchase. But the prices are quite a bit higher. So to get that 4-2 with the pool, you're looking more around the 500,000 range in Westchase. You still have HOAs and CDDs in Westchase as well because of how designed the area is, but it does feel really nice. I was actually meeting with some potential clients on Saturday. They were in town, so I just came to their hotel and sat down with them and kind of talked through timeline of their move. And they asked, what's the area that people wish they could live in? And I ended up recommending Westchase. You know, some people want that beach life. Some people want their own dock in their backyard. But if you're moving to a city like Tampa, you have a young family, or you have kids in school, Westchase is usually your highest choice. Now, maybe you can or can't afford it, but that was how I answered them. And I've seen that be pretty true among people that move here, but also among people that have lived here a long time. They're leveling up a few houses and then they want to land in Westchase. All right, my number four recommended area is kind of the town and country and Citrus Park area, which is kind of on both sides of Westchase. And it's pretty similar to Westchase, not as thoughtfully designed, but it's quite a bit cheaper. And these areas I end up recommending because someone is saying something like, I wanna live close to the city, I want access to restaurants and things like that, but I also want pretty easy access to the beach. These areas, you can hop down on Highway 60 and just cut over to Clearwater Beach or Honeymoon Island, or even down to like Bel Air or St. Pete Beach. And it's quite a bit easier access than a place like Wesley Chapel or Brandon, two nicer beaches. And that's usually why I end up recommending those specific areas. Town and Country has actually been receiving some press lately for how fast it is growing. All right, number five most recommended area is Largo. Largo also is growing very quickly. Largo is very similar to Clearwater, but it feels like a way smaller town. Largo is just south of Clearwater over here in Pinellas County, and it kind of stretches across most of this whole county. You know, it has access to all of the amenities, the shopping and things like that in Clearwater, and then has beautiful beaches itself, and then access to all these beautiful beaches. And Largo just has a little bit slower pace than Clearwater. Part of this is because there's not this main road going through it like there is in Clearwater, that Highway 60 that connects pretty much Clearwater Beach all the way to Brandon on the other side of Tampa. That makes Clearwater seem kind of congested to me. So Largo gives you a little bit slower pace, gives you, you know, the same style houses, the same amenities that Clearwater offers, but a little bit slower. The homes in Largo are older, typically. They're typically like block style ranch, Florida typical homes. You see kind of some shots here of some homes that are really close to the water, and even these homes are actually kind of boring. And that's okay. I mean, people use their landscape to, you know, make their house unique or even paint and things like that. But it is so close to the water. Okay, my number six most recommended area is the North Pinellas County area, which I kind of will kind of lump all this together because it's a few small towns. So you have Tarpon Springs and East Lake, which are kind of the north stretch of this county. And then you have Palm Harbor and Dunedin, which are just south of that. And it's kind of this whole north stretch, north of Clearwater for the whole north side of the county. There's a couple little small towns that make up this area, and it's a lot slower pace than other areas in the Tampa region. I like to include Trinity in this, which is actually in Pasco County. And it's technically kind of Newport Richey. It's an area that's being developed pretty quickly, and it's kind of this region of Newport Richey that kind of flows into Odessa and Keystone. So some of this is very developed and like new construction. Other parts of this are older homes, rural, some ranch areas, things like that. But this stretch, you know, Tarpon Springs, Palm Harbor, Dunedin over here on the Gulf Coast has beautiful beaches, has a lot of home options, old to new, but there's not a lot of new construction. So if you are looking for new construction, this would be a difficult area. This is the region of Tampa that I live in and that my wife's family is, like, my wife was born and raised here in Tarpon Springs. I really like this area. As someone who didn't grow up here, this feels like a really unique and special place to me. And these towns have some rich, unique history, and they really enjoy that about themselves. I'll have a Tarpon Springs vlog tour coming up pretty soon where I can show you some of the areas that Tarpon Springs is so famous for. In some of these areas, there's a little bit of new construction, but there's really not much. A lot of the houses are older, and then some of the developers, like Pioneer Homes, which is a local developer here in Tarpon Springs, has built a lot of villas and townhouses and single family homes over the past 20 years, and they've established a lot of neighborhoods in this area. They have a current development, what's it called, River Bend, which is just north of the Anclote River in Tarpon Springs. I think it's pretty much sold out, but there's all kinds of houses in the area. If you're looking for that typical Florida style 4-2 with or 4-3 with a pool, you're thinking of that stucco and the clay roof. That's gonna be closer to 450 in this area. And that's really just because there's not as many homes in this area. I hope you found this information useful. I wanted to approach the topic a little differently and talk about what I actually end up recommending to people when they're thinking about moving here. If you have any questions, please comment down below or reach out anytime. My number and email are right there on the screen. Thank you for watching.